Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making apple dippers, and you're probably familiar with those. Those are just slices of apples that you dip into caramel. And what I have here are a couple of Granny Smith apples. You can do as many as you want to of this, but we'll basically be using caramels. These are Kraft caramels that are wrapped individually, and you'll need to unwrap those and put them in the top of a double boiler. Or if you don't have a double boiler, just put them in a pan and then put that pan over boiling water. And our water should be boiling over here. It is. So what I'm going to do is place this right over the boiling water. I've got a big spoon so I can stir it. And honestly, I didn't put very many in because I'm making these for Rick and for me. And Carter might drop by this afternoon. If so, might try them out on him. He loves them from some of the fast food places around here. But you're just going to let these melt. However, if you let them melt and then cool off to where they need to be cool, they will congeal. They'll be back into this form again. So what we're going to do is once they have melted, we're going to be adding some half and half. So let me get these melted, get my half and half measured, and get ready to finish them up. You can see from my bag that I have a lot of caramels left over. This is a 14 ounce bag and it holds about 50 of these, so I counted out 25 and put in my double boiler. And I've been stirring, and you can see the water is bubbling, but I stir until you don't see any cubes any longer, and it's all just, maybe it's very stiff, but it's all melted the best we can do. Here, I'm going to turn this off because I don't need that additional heat. At this point, as I mentioned earlier, if you just try to dip your apples in them, they're too hot. It's too hot. But if you let it cool down, then it's back to this consistency, so you can't dip it. So what you're going to do is use some half and half, or you could actually just use regular milk if you wanted to. This is a richer flavor, but I've measured out 1/2 cup. I'm going to put half of that in, and we'll see what happens. So this would be 1/4 cup going in. And that's about right. And what I'm going to do is just stir that around. The goal here is not to boil the half and half. It's just to get it combined. Now, if I do have to apply heat for that to happen, because it immediately cools down the caramel and makes it want to set up, I will turn on heat if necessary. But I think if we stir long enough, that caramel is hot enough that it will just kind of blend in. So give me a second here and I'll try to get this blended together, and if I do anything different, I will tell you. I have mixed up the half and half with the melted caramel, and this is the consistency I have. Now, it's just a matter of preference. If you would like it thinner than that, remember it's going to be a little thicker after it cools. This for me would be way too thin if I was dipping apples in it. That would have a tendency to run down my hand, I think. So I'm trying to get it to a point where it would make a nice consistency once it's cool. And for me, I'm stopping with 1/4 cup. I didn't put any extra in. So we'll bring it over to our workspace. And the main thing that happens with this is that it cools off. So you can just let it sit at room temperature and cool. And as far as your apples are concerned, I wouldn't cut those until I was ready to use them. Or if you're sending them in a lunchbox or something like that, then cut them in the morning instead of the night before if you can. Although if you'll put a little lemon juice with them, they'll keep nice and fresh looking much longer. So we'll probably do that anyway. So we have some waiting to do, and I'll come back and prepare the apples when this is cooled off. We're ready to serve up our apple dippers. And what I have here is just a serving for one person, really. This is probably one complete Granny Smith apple, and it was a small apple to begin with. And I have a little space here in the center to put some of the dipping sauce. And this is what it looks like after it has cooled down. So it's liquid, it's not solid like those cubes of caramel, but it can be to your liking in terms of how liquid you want to get it. I'm going to put some out right here in the center between my two little stacks of apples, and that's going to look nice. And then I'll just return this to where it was. Obviously, it would have served more than one person, probably two, very well. But I'll save that for Carter in the afternoon. He really loves this at a fast food restaurant. What you're going to do is just take your slice of apple. Don't let these sit out with the air touching them. If you keep them in water, either salted water or water with lemon juice, or if you just splash some lemon juice on them, they will stay nice and clean without brown spots on them a lot longer. But when you're ready to eat one, just take your apple and dip it. Let's get some on there. And I'm sure a lot of kids like the caramel part more than the apple, but it's a good combination. You could use this sauce for a sundae over ice cream, but if you could get your kids to using this sauce over apples, then you're getting them to eat an apple very easily. It's really good. Hope you enjoy it.